Hello, welcome to another Developer Diary. Yesterday evening and today I felt pretty anxious about the game. I felt like, oh, there's so many things we have to do and there's not enough time, and obviously it's a very negative feeling, but fortunately I'm actually dealing with it pretty well because I've sort of transformed the anxiety into something else. So basically what I've been doing is I've been taking all the things that we need to do and then putting them in our bug database. We use Bugzilla for issue tracking and whatnot. It's free and it's okay. Honestly, I've never found a bug database that I really like, that I feel is really great, but we're not exactly using it for bugs. It's more task management, and Bugzilla has some stuff in there for that too, it seems. But just the act of sort of compiling my thoughts and taking them and putting them in this external bug database has really been helpful. Ordinarily I keep track of little lists of, oh, you know, for this thing we need that, and then I sort of give out people tasks as they come along. And, well, it's kind of stressful because there's some things where it's like, oh, I forgot about that, or I was putting something off and I didn't realize the dependencies. But the nice thing about actually having a more formalized process is you can put in the dependencies. You can put everything in that you're thinking of now and just mark it a very low priority, and then you can, you know, when people get to it, they'll get to it, or it's always there to remind you. So I found that interesting, and actually I think maybe I'll start putting my own issues in there, because ordinarily I just, you know, have my own to-do list. But I think maybe that sort of formalized process might help me as well when I feel personally overwhelmed, not just overwhelmed in terms of the entire project. So it's definitely something I'm working on, trying to figure out how to reduce the anxiety, and also I think it will help the game in general, because one of the things with our current project is that everyone works remotely. I don't live in the same city as anyone else on the team. One of the teammates is in another country. He's in Taiwan on the other side of the earth. And so having that bug database and sort of formalized to-do lists can really help sort of sync schedules, because he's working when I'm asleep and I'm working when he's asleep, and actually there's a couple hour overlap in the morning because he works super late in Taiwanese time, and so there's a couple hours of overlap in the morning where we can sort of ping each other. But it's been really helpful to have that formalized bug database, just because, I mean, even we're working with Joe Grabowski again, who, if you're not familiar, he was the artist on Retrograde, and so I'm working with him again. But he works in Michigan and works strange hours for whatever reason, so I think this also helps us, even though we're, you know, only 3 hours of time zone difference. I try to work similar hours to my wife, who works for the LA Unified School District, and so she leaves at like 7:30 in the morning, so I try to get to work at, you know, 7:30 or 8, and by get to work I mean walk from our bedroom to my office, which I think working the same hours as her has been really great for our relationship, just because when she's home, I'm home in quotation marks. But working from home and working remotely is tough, and honestly I think I would rather have an office and I would rather work in the same space as my employees, or, well, everyone's a contractor for business reasons, but and some of them are even doing work for free. And everyone's doing work for cheap, so I've been very fortunate that the people I want to work with are really excited about our project and are willing to go the extra mile, even though there's not a lot of financial incentive at the moment. But I think for me, with anxiety, I think having an office would be kind of nice, because then when I go home, I could sort of leave work behind. But I'm basically always at work, even when I'm home, because I work from home. Although, I don't know if that would really stop me from worrying about work in the evenings. I suspect not, especially, you know, given that we're in such a connected world, and I always have that, you know, line of email or whatever to work and other people on the project. So hopefully I'll be able to sort of figure out how to take a breath and separate myself from work more and more, because I think, you know, I'm constantly thinking about work, and that contributes to my insomnia when I think about work right before bed. So anyway, hopefully some of this is interesting. I think I'm learning as I go on how to be a better game developer, and hopefully you guys can learn with me.